But it is important to emphasize that the increase in agricultural production is essential based in productivity gains. In other words, the production has been increasing much more than the planted area due to the increase of the yields. As a matter of that, Argentina is the first world exporter of soybean meal and soybean oil, and the second world exporter of corn and sorghum. On the other hand, Brazil is situated as the first world exporter of beef and poultry meat, and the second exporter in the world of the soybean and its products. But I want to give you an example. For example, taking into account the world production and consumption of the four basic products, rice, corn, soybean, and wheat, between 2000 and 2008, it shows that the world suffered a deficit of almost 100 million tons of these commodities during that period. But if we subtract the contribution made by the southern region, especially Argentina and Brazil, the world's deficit on those products would have been over 500 million tons. Within this current context, the southern region has natural conditions to become a main supplier of food and biofuel for the continent and for the world. The region has important water resources, it still has a viable land that allows a significant increase of the production by means of the both of the application of technologies that boost the performance and productivity in sustainable conditions. In other words, the region is called to play a relevant role in the future increase of agriculture and livestock production of the world, and without forgetting the need of applying measures that allow a reduction on the effects that the worldwide climate change are causing. And entering to other point, what happened last year? In the last 2 years, the world has lived a series of events that had marked the overall agriculture and livestock sector. First of all, the rise of the food prices that happened at mid-2008 was experienced in the South region as opportunity rather than a risk. The incentive of the prices led the producer to obtain increase in their productivity and to improve the modernization of the agricultural sector. But when the world economic crisis arrived, it altered deeply the scenario under which the economies of the region countries were operating. The countries faced the impact of the world economic crisis with a battery of measures oriented to maintain or restore the basic condition of the economy, to reduce the negative impact over the terminated sector, and especially to reduce or avoid the deterioration of life levels of the most vulnerable population. In this specific issue, I want to say that it's important to point out that the crisis has increased the value of the policy's role and the quality of the regulation and institutions. But as I mentioned, the region has enormous opportunities in the agricultural sector due to this competitive advantage. But it's important to point out that the continuity of the application of distorted policies in the international trade of commodities constitute a key element in the inequity of the income distribution, in the loss of the resources, and the limitation of the policies in the developing countries. Measures that limit the commerce, taking into account issues like sanity, food safety, and environment, may be understood as non-tariff measures that are not done other than a new protectionist policies mask. But I'm here to talk about the future, which is our glance to the future. As I said, the Southern region is a region that is producer and supplier of food to the world, but at the same time, being developing countries, it is necessary to resort to every technological tool available that allows to improve the level of competitiveness and productivity of the sector. Among those tools, we could emphasize the important role that the use of modern biotechnology performs in the southern region's agriculture. The biotechnology, strictly speaking about the agriculture biotechnology, represents an alternative to overcome the challenge and producing more and in more sustainable conditions. I think that you know, in 2009, 134 million of hectares were planted with GM seeds in 25 countries around the world. South region, especially Argentina and Brazil, represented 35% of the GMs planted area in the world. The main crops of the region correspond to, you know, soybean, corn, and cotton. But in the other hand, with respect to the biofuel, the countries of the region consider this subject within their state policy due to their potential economic, environmental, and social benefits. Different ministers and governmental entities participate in the definition and application of the biofuel policy within all the countries of the region. But now, going into the core of this discussion of in this forum, I consider that food and environmental safety, I believe that both subject matter represent the largest challenge of the feeding growing population we have to add to the other. We will have to find the way of increasing the production without deterioration even more the environment. On the other hand, we shall have to do it by adapting ourselves to the adverse conditions that the climate change are imposing on us. Given the importance of the effect of the climate change is considering as a priority that the countries, all of the countries, adapt and or support the adaptation and mitigation measures necessary for sustainable development. The challenge then is to progress toward a regional harmonization of national policies and positions in order to reduce the climate change's vulnerability, take advantage of the opportunity, and provide appropriate response to the new requirements. Undoubtedly, not only is necessary to increase production with better quality to supply the growing demand for food, but also is necessary to work for maintaining the sustainable condition of the natural resources. Finally, I want to say that only with the application of technological tools and the appropriate public policies, this achievement can be reached. Thank you very much.
Sandra should also be about her capacity to restrain her intervention, because it was a big fight between us since last night. She has a lot of things to say. Now, the question of non-trade barriers, which seems to be important. The more you liberalize trade, the more there's a risk that non-trade barriers may come up as a substitute. Raise a few questions, and you are not all three obliged to answer each, but probably this one. This question is that the CAP reflects primarily EU defensive interests, where the agricultural policies of the US reflect primarily, and of the Cairns Group, which is Argentina, reflect primarily on fights for markets replaced by fights for supplies, if there were to be shortages. Is this view still true?